गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज द अमाइंस। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ अमाइंस, लेटर ऑफ द क्लासिफिकेशन एंड द नॉमेनक्लेचर बाय कॉमन सिस्टम। सो इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ अमाइंस, दिस अमाइंस आर द नाइट्रोजिनस ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स, मीन्स दे कंटेन नाइट्रोजन इन देयर मॉलिक्यूल। नाइट्रोजिनस ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स विद द बेसिक कैरेक्टर, द अमाइंस आर बेसिक इन नेचर। द अमाइंस आर नाइट्रोजिनस ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स विच आर बेसिक इन नेचर। नाइट्रोजिनस ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स बेसिक इन नेचर, दे आर बेसिक इन नेचर। दिस अमाइंस आर प्रेजेंट इन मेनी नेचुरल प्रोडक्ट्स, मेनी बायोमॉलिक्यूल्स। द बायोमॉलिक्यूल्स लाइक प्रोटीन्स, देन द विटामिन्स, proteins, vitamins and hormones contain the amines, the nitrogenous organic compounds which are basic in nature are called amines, and they are found to be present in many biomolecules such as proteins, vitamins and hormones. These amines are actually defined as the derivatives of ammonia. See the definition. The derivatives of ammonia obtained by the replacement of one, two or three hydrogen atoms by alkyl groups or aryl groups are called the amines. Amines are the derivatives of ammonia, means they are derived from ammonia. NH3 is ammonia. From this NH3, when hydrogen is replaced by the alkyl group or aryl group, then there is a formation of amine. Here one hydrogen is replaced by one alkyl group. When two hydrogen atoms are replaced by two alkyl groups, there is also formation of amine. From this ammonia, when three hydrogen atoms are replaced by three alkyl groups, again there is a formation of amine. So in this way, the amines are obtained from ammonia, and therefore these amines are called the derivatives of ammonia, because they are derived from ammonia. They are obtained from ammonia, therefore they are called the derivatives of ammonia. How they are obtained? They are obtained by the replacement of one hydrogen atom, two hydrogen atoms or three hydrogen atoms from ammonia by the alkyl groups or aryl groups. Here the replacement of hydrogen is possible by the alkyl group or aryl groups. So in this way we can define the amines, the derivatives of ammonia, which are obtained by the replacement of one, two or three hydrogen atoms by the alkyl groups or aryl groups are called amines. Then after the definition of amines, the classification. Classification of amines. The amines are classified into three types. Primary amines, then secondary amines, and tertiary amines. Primary amines are those amines which are obtained by the replacement of single hydrogen atom from ammonia by the alkyl group or aryl group. The general formula is RnH2. These primary amines are obtained by the replacement of only one hydrogen from ammonia by the alkyl group or aryl group. Here example is CH3NH2, CH2H5NH2, then C6H5NH2. This is the aryl group, phenylamine, this is methylamine. So here only one hydrogen from ammonia is replaced by the alkyl group or aryl group. These are called the primary amines. In the primary amines, the functional group is amino group. Name of the functional group is amino group and the structure of the functional group is NH2. This NH2 group is the functional group of primary amines. In every primary amine, there is the presence of this functional group. Then secondary amines. These are the amines which are obtained by the replacement of two hydrogen atoms from ammonia by the alkyl groups or aryl groups. The general formula is written as R2NH. R2NH. This R may be the alkyl groups or aryl groups. For example, here CH3NH. Two methyl groups are attached to the nitrogen. This amine is obtained by replacement of two hydrogen atoms from ammonia by two methyl groups. Then C6H5NH. This is also the secondary amine. It is also obtained by the replacement of two hydrogen atoms by two aryl groups. The functional group in secondary amines is amino group. Name of the functional group is amino group. And the formula of the amino group is NH. NH. This is the amino group. This amino group is the functional group which is present in every secondary amine. You can see here, this is the amino group. This is the amino group. Amino group is the functional group of secondary amines. Third types of amines are the tertiary amines. These are defined as the amines which are obtained by the replacement of all the three hydrogen atoms from ammonia by alkyl groups or aryl groups. The general formula is R3N. R3N. All the three hydrogen atoms of ammonia are replaced by the alkyl groups or aryl groups. Example, CH3N. Three times CH3N. Or C6H5N. So here, these are the examples of tertiary amines. They are obtained by the replacement of all the three hydrogen atoms by the alkyl groups or aryl groups. The functional group in tertiary amines. Name of the functional group is trivalent nitrogen atom. Trivalent nitrogen atom or tertiary nitrogen atom. Instead of trivalent, we say tertiary nitrogen atom. Tertiary nitrogen atom. It is the functional group of tertiary amines. And the tertiary nitrogen is represented in this way. This is the representation of tertiary nitrogen. This tertiary nitrogen is present in every tertiary amine. Every tertiary amine contains the tertiary nitrogen. This is the functional group of tertiary amine. So this is the classification of amines as primary, secondary and tertiary. Further, the secondary and tertiary amines are classified into two types. Primary amines cannot be further classified, but the secondary and tertiary amines can be further classified into two types. The simple or symmetrical, and the second type is the mixed or unsymmetrical. Classification of secondary and tertiary amines. Secondary and tertiary amines are classified into two types. A is simple or symmetrical amines, and B is mixed or unsymmetrical amines. The secondary or tertiary amines are said to be simple or symmetrical when both or all the three alkyl or aryl groups are identical. For example, here CH3, CH3, NH. Here both the alkyl groups are similar, identical. C2H5O, C2H5O, NH. Dimethyl amine, diethylamine. Then C6H5O, C6H5O, NH. Diphenylamine, dimethylamine, diethylamine, diphenylamine. So here both the alkyl groups are identical. Here both the aryl groups are identical. So such amines are called the simple amines or symmetrical amines. Similarly, the tertiary amines, when all the alkyl groups or aryl groups are identical, then it is said to be the simple amine. Trimethylamine. Trimethylamine is the example of simple amine. It is a tertiary amine, but it is a simple amine. Then triethylamine, triethyl. This is triethylamine. This triethylamine is an example of simple amine. So tertiary and secondary, both types of amines are classified as simple and mixed. And all these are the examples of simple amines. These are the secondary amines, which are simple. These are the tertiary amines. These are simple amines. Now the mixed amines or unsymmetrical amines. In the secondary or tertiary amines, if different types of alkyl groups or aryl groups are attached to the nitrogen, then such amines are called the mixed or unsymmetrical amines. See here, this is a secondary amine. Here one ethyl group and one methyl group are attached to the nitrogen. Therefore, it is a mixed or unsymmetrical amine. Ethyl methyl amine. Then methyl propyl amine. Then methyl phenyl amine. These are the examples of mixed amines, secondary mixed amines. Similarly, the tertiary amines. Here two types of alkyl groups are there. Two alkyl groups, two types of alkyl groups. Diethyl methyl amine. Diethyl, two ethyl groups are there. Therefore, diethyl methyl amine. It is a tertiary amine, but it is classified as simple, mixed amine. Then CH3, N, C6H5O, C6H5O. Methyl diphenyl amine. Methyl diphenyl amine. It is a tertiary amine which is classified as mixed amine. So in this way, the secondary and tertiary amines can be classified into two types, the simple and mixed amine. The amine is said to be simple whenever both the alkyl groups or aryl groups are identical. In case of tertiary amine, when all the three alkyl groups or aryl groups are identical, then it is said to be the simple amine. In the mixed or unsymmetrical amine, when all the alkyl groups or aryl groups are identical, different, then it is said to be the mixed or unsymmetrical amine. These similar alkyl or aryl groups are there. Then the amines are also classified as aliphatic and aromatic amines. Aliphatic and aromatic. In an amine, whenever the hydrogen is replaced by hydrogen of ammonia is replaced by the alkyl group. This is the ammonia. When hydrogen is replaced by the alkyl group, the amine is said to be the aliphatic amine. And when the hydrogen from ammonia is replaced by the aryl group, then it is said to be aromatic amine. Aliphatic amines and aromatic amines. When the amine is obtained by the replacement of hydrogen from ammonia by the alkyl group, then it is called the aliphatic amine. And when the amine is obtained by the replacement of hydrogen by aryl group, then the amine is called as the aromatic amine. So this is also the classification of amines, aliphatic and aromatic. Here we can take some examples and we can classify them, whether the amine is primary or secondary or tertiary, then it is simple or mixed, aliphatic or aromatic. So here we can take some examples. C2H5 twice NH, then CH3, C2H5, then C6H5, CH3, then CH3, NH2, then CH3, NH2, then C6H5, then C2H5 three times N. So we have to classify these amines. Now here two ethyl groups are attached to nitrogen. Therefore, this is a simple amine. But here two hydrogen atoms of ammonia are replaced by the alkyl group. Therefore, it is a secondary amine. The functional group is NH, amino group. Functional group is amino group, therefore it is a secondary amine. Secondary. Simple secondary. This is tertiary because the functional group is tertiary nitrogen and therefore it is a tertiary amine. But here the different types of alkyl groups are there and therefore it is a mixed amine. Mixed tertiary. In the next example, again there is a tertiary. Tertiary nitrogen is the functional group, therefore there is a tertiary amine. And here two aryl groups and one alkyl group is there. Therefore, it is a mixed amine. Mixed tertiary. Then, here the functional group is NH2, that is the amino group. And therefore, it is a primary amine. In this amine also, the functional group is amino group. Therefore, it is a primary amine. It is a tertiary amine. Here, trivalent or tertiary nitrogen is there, therefore it is a tertiary amine. It is classified as a simple amine because all these three aryl groups are similar. Therefore, it is a simple tertiary amine. This is also a tertiary amine, but it is also a simple because here all the three alkyl groups are identical. Therefore, it is a simple tertiary amine. Now, there is one important point about the classification of amines. In case of alkyl halides and alcohols, we classify them as primary, secondary or tertiary depending on the nature of the carbon atom to which the functional group is attached. In the alkyl halides, RCH2X, RCHRX, R, alkyl halides. This is a primary alkyl halide, this is a secondary alkyl halide, this is a tertiary alkyl halide. Because here the functional group halogen is attached to the primary carbon, here the secondary carbon, and here tertiary carbon. Similarly in the alcohols. But in case of amines, the classification is not on the basis of nature of carbon atom. Amines are classified as primary, secondary, and tertiary, not on the basis of the carbon atom, nature of carbon atom, but on the basis of the functional group. If the amine contain NH2 group, then it is the primary. If it is contain NH group, then it is the secondary. And when it contain tertiary nitrogen, then it is the tertiary. Tertiary nitrogen, tertiary. NH, that is the imino group is there, then it is called secondary. And when amino group is there, then it is called primary. This is amino group. This is imino group. And this is the tertiary nitrogen. Whenever there is a presence of tertiary nitrogen, this is a tertiary amine. Imino group, secondary amine, amino group, primary amine. But in the alkyl halides and alcohols, the classification is only on the basis of the type of carbon to which the functional group is attached. This is the primary carbon, therefore primary amine. This is the secondary carbon, therefore secondary amine. This is the tertiary carbon, therefore it is the tertiary halide. Primary halide, secondary halide, and tertiary halide. CH3CCH3CH3Cl and CH3CCH3CH3NH2. These alkyl halides classified as a tertiary alkyl halide. Tertiary. It is a tertiary alkyl halide because here the halide, which is a functional group, is attached to the tertiary carbon. But here this amine is classified as the primary amine because here the classification is not on the basis of the type of carbon, it is on the basis of the functional group. This amine contains the amino group and therefore it is the primary amine. The classification of amine is never on the basis of the nature of carbon, it is only on the basis of the functional group. Amino group is present, therefore primary amine. Amino group is present, then secondary amine. Tertiary nitrogen is present, then it is the tertiary amine. So classification of amines is not on the basis of nature of carbon, it is only on the basis of the functional group. Whether there is a presence of amino group or amino group or tertiary nitrogen, that will decide the type of amine. But in alkyl halides and alcohols, the type primary, secondary, and tertiary is only decided by the nature of carbon to which the functional group is attached. When the carbon is primary, when the halogen or OH group is attached to the primary carbon, then the alkyl halide or alcohol is said to be primary alkyl halide or primary alcohol. In this way, there is a difference of classification of amines from rest of the compounds. So this is about the classification. Then the nomenclature of amines by common system. In the common system of nomenclature, the alkyl amines are named by writing the name of the alkyl group followed by the word amine. Name of alkyl group followed by word amine. The name of alkyl group is followed by the word amine. Here there is the use of suitable prefix. Suitable prefix is used to the name of alkyl group. A suitable prefix such as ion, iso, neo, secondary, tertiary, these are the suitable prefixes which are used for the name of the alkyl group. Write the name of the alkyl group, then write the word amine. Then, in case of simple amines, having two or three similar alkyl groups or aryl groups, there is the use of prefix such as di, tri, These are the prefixes which are attached to the name of the alkyl groups. Alkyl group or aryl group. These are the prefixes which are attached to the name of the alkyl group or aryl group if the amines are secondary or tertiary. If the amines are simple amines, then in case of simple amines, there is a use of the prefixes such as di or tri, which are used to the name of the alkyl groups. Let us see some examples. CH3NH2. The common name will be methylamine. Common name will be methylamine. Then CH3CH2NH2. Here the common name is ethylamine. Then CH3CH2CH2NH2. Here the common name is N-propyl. Now here the prefix is N, which is attached to the name of the alkyl group. N-propylamine. Then CH3CH3NH2. Here also the propyl group is there, but this is the isopropyl. Isopropyl. This is isopropyl group. Therefore, isopropyl amine. We use the prefix iso when one methyl group is attached to the last but one carbon. This is the last carbon, this is last but one carbon, and only one methyl group is attached to the last but one carbon. Then we use the prefix iso, isopropyl amine. Then the name of this amine is ethylene diamine. Ethylene diamine. The name of this amine is hexamethylene. Hexamethylene diamine. Hexamethylene diamine. Let us see some more examples. This is a secondary amine. It is a simple amine, therefore there is a use of prefix di, dimethylamine. This is a diethylamine. If the secondary or tertiary amines are mixed, then there is a use of alphabetical order. The alkyl groups are written in alphabetical order. Here, two different alkyl groups are there. Then write the names of these alkyl groups in the alphabetical order. Ethyl, methyl. Ethyl comes first. Ethyl, methylamine. Similarly, in case of tertiary amines, CH3, CH3, CH3. This is a simple amine. Therefore, there is the use of prefix tri. Trimethyl amine. When it is mixed, then write the names of the alkyl groups in the alphabetical order. Ethyl dimethyl amine. Ethyl dimethyl amine. CH2 double bond CH2NH2. Now this is the allyl group. Therefore its name is allyl amine. Allyl amine. Then we can take some examples of aromatic amines. C6H5. We can write in this way also. C6H5NH2. The common name is phenylamine. Because the name of the aryl group is phenyl. Phenylamine. or it is also known as aniline. Aniline, common name. Then C6H5, NH, C6H5. These are two similar aryl groups. It is a simple amine, therefore diphenylamine. Then CH3, NH, C6H5. This is a mixed amine, therefore its name will be methyl phenyl amine. Write the names in alphabetical order. Methyl phenyl amine. Then CH3 C6H5. Here two methyl and one phenyl group is attached to nitrogen, therefore dimethyl phenyl amine. Dimethyl phenyl amine. So in this way we can write the common names of the amines. The common names of the amines are obtained by writing the name of the alkyl group or aryl group followed by the word amine. There is the use of suitable prefix such as N, iso, neo, secondary, tertiary, which is attached to the name of the alkyl group. Further, if the amine is simple amine, then the names of the alkyl groups to the name of alkyl group, there is a use of a prefix such as di or tri. And if the amines are mixed amines, then the names of the alkyl groups or aryl groups are written in alphabetical order. So by following these rules, we can write the common names to the amines. Thank you.